Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Tatiana and this week's video is a bit different. I wanted to include more art into my channel, so I'm going to show you how I managed to make this digital illustration on Adobe Illustrator. Now, I've been seeing this art form increase in popularity a lot over the past couple of months, so I'm going to show you step by step how you can do it too. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Alright, let's get right into it. So I didn't exactly start filming this video when I actually started this portrait, so I went back and retraced my steps in order to show you guys exactly what I did. So the first tool that you want to use is the pen tool. I'm using Adobe Illustrator and I just use this to outline all major features of my face. I also use this to outline my hair and my clothes and just anywhere that I need to add blocks of color. Don't worry about the color of it because now we're going to change it. We're also going to play around with the width of the stroke as well as the style of the stroke in order to create a more realistic or at least more natural looking line. For the eyebrow, you want to go ahead and add a gradient to it and play around with the transparency of it. I basically chose both colors on either end of the gradient and just played around with the transparency, as I said, because once you place this on top of the skin, as you're about to see, it helps create more of a faded look or at least more of a natural eyebrow look. So I went back into the eye to create the actual iris. I just used the shape tool and created a circle, and then I added a stroke to that was darker than the actual eye color that I had. I also added a pupil in the middle, and then for the white part of the eye, I used the blob tool to just color in some white, send it to the back, and then use the eraser tool to erase anything that kind of came out of the lines. Now the lashes, oh my god, they took forever, but basically you have to make each as an individual stroke, and then you mess around with both the width of the stroke as well as the style of the stroke and choose that triangular looking stroke. If the stroke shows up in the opposite way, then just hit the reflect tool in order to get the stroke style going in the right direction. The rest of this is just me blocking in more color. Alright, so now I slowed down this video again to show you how I contoured my face. Basically, I just used the pen tool again to make some blobs and I chose a color that was a bit darker than my actual skin tone. And then I used the opacity to drop it down and add some Gaussian blur in order to help it blend in with my skin a bit more. I then repeated the same exact process with any highlights that I could find on my face. As you can see, I'm about to start looking a bit ridiculous, but trust me, it's worth it. So now for the clipping mask. What you're going to do is you're going to take the outline of the face, you're going to copy it, and then you're going to place it in front of everything. You're then going to select that as well as the two contours that I have along my roots, and you're going to create a clipping mask by going to Object, Clipping Mask, and then Make. Now for the eyes, I had to play around with this a bit more. Basically, I created two different blobs, whatever you want to call them. The one in the back along my crease is more for my eyeshadow. So again, this was playing around with the opacity as well as adding a Gaussian blur. Now I wanted to highlight my lid, so again I chose a lighter color, but this time I did not add any blur to it. I just liked the harsher look that it gave, and then I repeated the same exact thing with the area under my eyes. Also, don't forget to add the two little circles on your iris in order to indicate a highlight in your eyes. Now with the nose, you oftentimes just want to suggest that it's there as opposed to outlining every single feature of it. So I just went ahead and shadowed and highlighted the areas that I felt were important. Now man, the lips, that also took me a long time. I just could not figure it out. So you'll see me playing around with it a lot. But the key to it is basically just having some parts, not too many parts, but some major parts that are darker than the others, mostly the area where the two lips connect, as well as the bottom part of it. And then if you just add one little area of highlight to your lips, it's just gonna help make it look fuller and healthier. Now back to the inner corner of my eyes. Again, I just added another little highlight to draw attention to the eyes. Again, this is dropping the opacity and adding some Gaussian blur. And we're back to the lips. All right, finally we made it into the hair. For this, you're just gonna create some ragged lines. They're gonna look kind of funny, but it'll come together in the end. The trick to this, at least for the outer edges, is to make it flow in the same direction that your hair is going. This is gonna make it look most natural. For me, I chose 3 basic colors to use in all of my hair. Basically, I chose the base color, and then I chose a lighter color and a darker color. The darker color was for the roots and the lighter color for the highlights. You're gonna probably be using clipping mask here as well to avoid having any strands of hair on the face that shouldn't be there. I also went in and, again, using the pen tool, I added some strokes to signify individual strands of hair, and then I just played with the width of them as well as the stroke type or style type of them just to create some variation. And the last thing I did to add more highlight was I used the blob tool and chose an even lighter color and just kind of drew on the areas that I wanted there to be extra highlight. I then dropped the opacity and added the Gaussian blur, as I'm sure you know the routine by now, and played around with that in order to give my hair more dimension. And finally, we're on to the background. So for the background, as you can see, I basically tried every color of the rainbow until I found one that I liked. Now this green was very nice. I still really like it, but as I was doing it, I thought it'd be even cooler to make this whole portrait thematic. And since I was already wearing a lot of red and blue, and the fact that the 4th of July had just passed, I decided to make it 4th of July themed. I just started adding some white stars to it. To add some variation, I just made some of them more transparent than others. I also tried adding some extra lines in the background just because I wanted to bring some of that red into it, but ultimately I didn't like it and I ended up taking it out. Now the name was a whole nother challenge because I wanted to make it a bit different and to kind of go in with my YouTube style, but this type wasn't exactly super legible, so I ended up scratching it and I just stuck with like a dark blue version of it. Now this is the final product. I went ahead and added a color palette to the side of it. And yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed it and were able to learn a thing or two from it. If you liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And if you do happen to try this out, let me know in the comments below. All right, well, thanks again, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.